In this tutorial, I'll be showing you how to download and play itch.io games for Windows, timestamps, links, and a written transcript with FAQ for this video will be in the description below. First things first, we'll start by heading to 7zip.org to pick up 7zip, an unpacking program that allows us to extract .zip and .rar files. You'll want one of these two links at the top left of the page, and depending on your Windows operating system, you can choose 32-bit or 64-bit. If you aren't sure which one relates to you, then you'll want to right-click your Windows icon on your taskbar, go up to System, and select it. On the About page, you can find your information next to system type. For me, it is 64-bit, so I'll want the second link, and if you're running 32-bit, then pick the first link. For this tutorial, I will be saving it to my desktop for ease of use, but it doesn't matter where you save your files. If you are using Google Chrome and a Windows Explorer doesn't pop up when clicking a download link, it should still download to whatever your location is set. But if you want to fix this, then left-click the three dots at the top right of your browser, go to Settings, Advanced, turn Ask where to save each file before downloading off to the left and on to the right. After that, try downloading something and your Windows Explorer should pop up. Let's go and get some games from itch.io. There are a ton of free games available on the website. At the top of the page, you can enter a search term for a specific game or creator. On the left is where you can browse by price, popular tags, and even randomized if you want to find a new game. Find the game that you want, then click on it. You'll be taken to the creator's page where you can view their description of the game, the type of file, comments, and the button to download. We'll want to click that and a new window should pop up, giving you the option to support the creator, or you can select no thanks, just take me to the downloads. Let's select that and a new page will come up and you should see a download button. Clicking it will open up your Windows Explorer. Like 7zip, you can choose any place to save your game. If you don't get these additional windows and a save as window still comes up, don't be alarmed. You can still proceed to rename the game and save the download normally. Recently, a commenter, LethalMoo182, had a problem with a game called the Upside Down, a .zip file. So I downloaded that and my pick for a .rar file is the Dungeon Drafters demo. Now that we have everything together, let's start with installing 7zip by clicking on the Setup app. A user control window will pop up asking if you want to run 7zip and have it make changes to your device. We'll want to select yes. The setup window will pop up with the destination of where it will install. By default, it'll be on your C drive, and if you click the three dots next to it, a new window will come up where you can install it in another location or other storage device. I'll be keeping it to my C drive, so I'll hit install. Once 7zip is finished, we can get our game set up. I'll start with the Upside Down, the .zip file. So we'll right click on our .zip or .rar file, whichever one you have at this time, and then go to Open With, choose another app, More Apps, 7zip File Manager. Checkmark this box, always use this app to open .zip files, or if you are doing this with a .rar file, then it will say always use this app to open .rar files. Once that is done, you can then click OK. If for some reason you can't find the 7zip file manager in this list, keep scrolling down until you see look for another app on this PC. Click on it and a new window will pop up. Find where your 7zip installation is located. So for me, it is in my program files on my C drive where I installed it. Select 7zfm and then click open. Your games should have the 7Z logo over them now, and if they don't, then right click on your desktop and hit refresh. This will refresh your icons on your monitor, and now we can go ahead with extracting the games. Right click on your game, so in my case, it's the upside down. Select 7-Zip, extract files. This will open up a new window where the top bar will show where the game will extract. Just like earlier, if you click on the three dots, you can save your extracted game to another location. The second box is the name of the folder that will be created once it's finished. Make sure not to leave a period at the end of the last word, or you will get an error when opening the extracted folder. So I will keep it simple and just rename it to the upside down without spaces. The save destination will be to my desktop, and then I'll hit OK. I will do the same process for Dungeon Drafters, the .rar file. It takes a bit of time, but soon you'll get the hang of it and you'll be able to download and extract games pretty quickly. The last thing to do is start up each game. Let's give the upside down a go by opening the extracted folder and double clicking the .exe. All right, it seems to be working just fine. And now let's try Dungeon Drafters. The same way as before, we go into the folder and start up the game from the .exe. There we go. That is how you download and install itch.io games manually. If you want an easier method, in my opinion, where you can keep all of your games in one place, then consider downloading the itch.io client. I will have a video that will appear here on setting that up. If you want to see how to download GameJolt games manually, then click this video. Feel free to subscribe to the channel and leave a like so YouTube can bump up this video for others to see. Until next time, take care.